Hello and welcome back. This is the last video for section 11, and here I will talk a bit about for the case of polynomial regression. So if we are not technically fitting a straight line, but if we have one input and we are fitting polynomials of this input, how we can avoid multicollinearity for that case. So let's see what that means. The specific problem I want to discuss is if we have a polynomial model, so if x and y are in R, but we want to fit the model y is beta 0 plus beta 1 x and so on up to beta p x to the p plus noise, then we need to use that model to construct our data. So we have p inputs here, but they are all computed from this 1 x. And what we get is for the data matrix, we have always our 1 for the intercept, and then we would here write first sample squared up to first sample to the p, and then the second row would be second sample squared up to second sample to the p. We can do that, no problem. But the problem I discuss in this section is that if you do that naively, then you can often get problems with multicollinearity, which we discussed in a previous section, which makes your estimate less stable. Your estimates hat beta j will have high variance, and it makes everything a bit more difficult. So that is something we want to avoid. And here I want to just show you a trick how to avoid that. So trick one is very simple, namely the basic version of the trick is instead of the model I wrote here, you can use a slightly modified version by subtracting the mean of the x here. That mathematically makes no difference. We can still describe every polynomial of degree p here, and if we subtract the mean, just the coefficients will change, but we have the same space of models available. But the matrix we get here, the design matrix, is different, and it turns out the new design matrix, if you do it like that, has much better conditioning. So the condition number is lower, and there are fewer problems with multicollinearity. Good, so that's the first version. But then there is a more systematic way of doing that and getting a better result. Namely, what we really want is for the columns of x to be orthogonal. What does this mean? That means, so if we say x is xij, where I ranges from 1 to n and j ranges from 0 to p, then we want the inner product of the columns. I don't know what to call the j's column. Let's just write it out. So we want some xij, xik, I from 1 to n. We want that to equal 0 for all j different from k. That condition here means the inner product of column j and column k equals 0. And the inner product being 0 means two vectors, two columns here are orthogonal. Good. And now in that situation, we compute the rows as functions of x, and we apply the same function to x1 for the first row as we apply to x2 for the second row. So we can write x is 1, and then let's call it psi. So psi 1 of x1 up to psi p of x1. That's the functions to compute the columns from the given data, and then I apply the same functions to x2 for the next row. So I do psi 1 of x2 up to psi p of x2, and so on. And that condition here for orthogonality, if I write it in that notation, then I get sum I from 1 to n, and now row I column j is psi j of xi, and row I column k is psi k xi. That must be 0 then. So if we can achieve this, then we are good. And to make that complete, what we should do is we should write psi 0 of x1 and psi 0 of x2 here, and just say psi 0 of any x equals 1. Then we have a bit more uniform notation. Good. Now, question is, can we find functions psi j to make that happen? And turns out we can, and we can do better. Namely, we wanted to write polynomials, and here I just built them up from monomials, but that is not really required. I can write any first order polynomial here, like x minus x bar or x, it does not matter. I can write any second order polynomial here, like x squared or x minus x bar squared or any other second order polynomial. And since we can still choose the betas, that does not restrict us. So the idea is choose pi j to be a polynomial of degree j. Good. And it turns out that is possible. You can find these polynomials, and in this module I'm not explaining how that is done, but it is not particularly difficult if you try. And the thing we are going to use here is there is an R function to compute such polynomials for us, and that's what I explain in the notes. So I want to stop this explanation here. I think I have outlined what are we trying to do. We are trying to make X have orthogonal columns so that there cannot possibly any multicollinearity. And we do that by choosing a bit more general polynomials for our basis here than we had done before. And there is an R package which chooses them for us based on data. And the condition we need is this one, which is the one it turns out is possible to achieve, which then gives us orthogonality of the columns. And that removes all problems you could have with conditioning of the design matrix. And you will see an example in the notes that that actually works quite nicely in practice. Good. So that concludes our discussion from section 11. And I'll see you again in a few days when we are starting to discuss section 12. Until then, bye-bye.